and we are back here at SWS.
The only way to win is to be the first competitor to climb the ladder and obtain possession by any means possible of the coveted championship title.
Back here at SWS Mega Slam, Dave Adams in the ring, and we are about to begin this fantastic ladder match. I can't wait to see this. All the way up, making his way to the ring, Max Stardom. He wants what's at the top of that ladder, and he's coming in to get it. Ellis Taylor looking to get the championship as well, getting his head into the game. Charlie Tiger in the ring.
With the legendary Juicy J. Let's go. With all this bread, I need a bigger stomach. My name ring bell so you can hear me coming. Made it all on my own. They ain't give me nothing. And I'm still standing like a set of crutches. Ain't no way they can forget my name. I'm a legend. Do me one.
Check you and me, and do your job. Ferg is the name, Ben Baller did the chain. Tono for the watch, Prezi plain Jane. Yeah, the guinea chain, rest in peace to my
career. In the world, the final birth is here. It's a
Oliver, the SWS Cruiserweight Champion. This man went through hell and back in order to get the job done at last month's show, SWF 100. Sean Black just happened to be on hand for that. I can't say I agree with the man what he did in order to get the belt, but I must say this, this man has what it takes to be SWF Cruiserweight Champion. I can't take anything away from him. He fought through two matches in order that single night in order to get that belt. Wait, what is this? Casey Navarro may be a surprise entrance in this Cruiserweight title defense. Looking to capture the gold tonight in this ladder match. Let's see if he's got what it takes to get the job done. And there is the bell as Navarro and Oliver have some choice words. Now they're all moving in.
What? What? Casey Navarro, the Sky Reaper, is here at SWF.
What a surprise entrance into this SWF Cruiserweight title.
It was going to be tough enough as a four-way for Jordan Oliver, but now he's got to deal with a fifth competitor.
And Max Stardom doing the right thing, sitting outside and letting these bums beat the mess out.
I got to look into the eyes of Max Stardom in the ring. This guy, he's got the eye of the tiger. He came here prepared. He could definitely be the dark horse in this match.
Look at him watching. Just watching.
Beautiful head scissors takedown from Casey Navarro. And to no surprise to me, how appropriate, how apropos, the Sauce God Jordan Oliver and the Sky Reaper, Casey Navarro, they might be born to fight each other forever. Some of the greatest rivalries in SWF have come in the form of these two young cruiserweight standouts.
Dave, I have to agree with you there. I watched this young man at SWF 100, and he showed and proved to me.
This action is booming all over the place as Casey Navarro now with an advantage over Jordan Oliver, the champion, but no pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts or disqualifications.
Oh, he gets taken down.
Action so hard hitting, you can feel it through the camera here. SWF in HD doesn't get any realer than this.
You're right about that, dude.
Unbelievable, as Ellis Taylor tripped up Casey Navarro, and now Jay the Key Evans, he's in the ring here. Tope con Hilo from Jay the Key Evans. The key to success is climbing that ladder.
What's Jordan gonna do here?
He's gonna make some sauce.
Whoa. What a move.
Beautiful plunger to the outside, clearing that top rope. And down goes the competition. Down goes everybody but...
Not Navarro. Navarro's in the ring by himself. What's he going to do?
Whatever he wants, because he ain't no kid no more. This is KC Navarro. He's graduated to the big leagues. And the Sky Reaper. Wow!
Oh, my goodness. And he just single-handedly took out every single competitor in this match. Except for, if you're paying attention, Max Stardom, who just now gets off the ladder and bringing it into the ring because he's just using the old brain.
This is beautiful strategy because Casey Navarro certainly is probably stung a little bit after that move. Casey Navarro could have just opened up a championship reign here for Max Stardom.
And this is how you do it. You let these guys beat the mess out of each other and then you run in and
you capture. Absolutely. You got to be there. You got to be an opportunist. Well, Max Stardom certainly realizing now.
Every Everyone noticing that.
The foxes have come out to hunt, and he might be the hunted. He's thinking twice about it.
He cautiously moved down to the back.
Because it's easy to get high up on that ladder, but even easier to fall off that ladder.
And now he's going to use it as a weapon against everybody.
Round and round he goes.
There goes
Evans. There goes Tiger. There goes Taylor. There goes the sauce gun. Oh, Casey Navarro misses. Misses again. This kid, no more. But he can't escape that.
That was a nice solid tip. Oh, man. What's he going to do? The sharpshooter crowd showing in.
He said, all right, screw it. Oh, he's doing a little twerk on the head of Casey Navarro. And now banging that head into the canvas.
It looks like it's going to go on forever, Dave.
I would be okay with that. As now, as Max Dunham taunting the crowd.
You know who I am now, right?
That's right. No, people may not have known who he was, but early on in this match, nobody's going to forget the name Max Dunham. And a famouser from Bayville's favorite bouncing baby boy, Jay the Key Evans.
Should have been paying more attention.
And now, it's Evans with Charlie Tiger in the ring. Oh, beautiful plant of the head to the knee. Charlie Tiger wanted to show everybody who's the man.
Setting the ladder up. What do you think he's going to go here with this?
Hopefully, something fantastic filled with gloom and doom for somebody else. Possibly the champion.
What do we got here? Oh, and he throws his face right into the ladder. Jordan Oliver.
Beautiful swing blade from Jay the Key Evans to the champion. Jay Evans now. Possibly going to use that as a platform to springboard off of. But wait, the sauce gun.
This is a dangerous spot here.
Springboard Spanish fly off the ladder. Oh. And a swanton bomb from Ellis Taylor. And now Charlie Tiger. Oh. Corkscrew brain buster. Holy expletive.
And now we got Navarro on the top rope.
450 splash. No pinfalls here, though. That took a lot out of KC. That took a lot of everybody. Once again, who's the opportunist waiting? Max Stardom.
He is not. This
is amazing.
He is not wasting any time.
This is awesome.
Once again, letting these guys beat the mess out of each other. What? Now Navarro. He kicks him off. Navarro going to pull Stardom down. Misses with a clothesline. Oh, a kick to the gut. Max Stardom pushes him out like a bag of garbage and goes back to trying to retreat.
There it is, rung by rung, Max Stardom. Could he surprise everybody? But Jay Evans says nope. Thrust kick, followed by a roundhouse kick. And now a big kick and a neck breaker from Stardom, looking to be the star, the show stealer in this match.
What a series of moves. I couldn't have said it better, Dave. You're absolutely right.
I like this guy a lot. This guy was meant for SWF Stardom. No pun intended. Simply put, he picked the right name. He's got a brash attitude. He's highly intelligent. As Casey Navarro tries the crossbody splash.
And now what's he going to do?
Wow. Hurts his own beehive, but slamming the head of Casey Navarro into that solid steel ladder. And now, basement dropkick from Charlie Tiger. Ellis Taylor now back in the ring. Charlie picks him up.
He's got him up. What's he gonna do? Jordan.
The sauce god. Oh no, precarious spot. Oh no. Caught up top. Charlie Tiger's got the whole crew. Power slam and a power bomb in one. Combo breaker.
Wow.
We've seen a little bit of everything in this match.
Yeah, this is some fantastic action, dude. And everybody all laid out on the floor.
As I say, everybody in the club getting tips. But these guys, they're not drunk off of alcohol. They're drunk off of adrenaline and the bumps and bruises they've taken in this match. taking a toll on their bodies, could be taking years off their young careers, all for the championship title hanging above the ring, literally hanging in the balance, the SWF Cruiserweight Championship.
Breaking their body for this crowd out here tonight. Who's coming to the feet first? Looks like everybody's got a hand on the ladder. Now they're all pulling, tugging at each other.
Now this is what I like to see. And Casey Navarro, he's gonna try and get the championship by standing on top of the ladder. Hey, by any means necessary. Wow, that's actually pretty cool. What are you doing, guys? Oh my God. And now Charlie Tiger trying to get him up on the shoulders as Casey Navarro, he gets caught.
Ow!
Power bomb on the ladder. And now Charlie Tiger taken out. It's a free for all. As Max Stardom and Jordan Oliver double thrust kick to Ellis Taylor's face. And Jay Evans. And double super kicks in stereo. These guys, oh man, same move at the same time.
They look like they're on the same page for a moment.
You don't want to be on the same page in this match for too long, let me tell you that much. Max Stardom! Oh, and Casey Navarro in one fluid motion. Hurricane Corona takedown. Wow!
Navarro takes them out.
Round and round he goes where he lands. Only Casey Navarro knows as the champion taken out of the action with that hellacious Hurricane Corona takedown to the extreme. Round and round he went. Now they just need, one of them needs to get that ladder and get to the top. The ladder of success to reach that championship goal.
That's what it's all about, Dave. You can do all the moves in the book, but if you can't get to that goal, you're not doing anything. Nobody's walking out here. Navarro climbing
there
the ladder.
There he is. Could he, looking to become a multi-time Cruiserweight champion.
The Tiger in the ring.
Come on, Tiger, show him what you can do. Oh, wow. Blue Thunder Bomb, but there's no pinfalls here. That's why he didn't go for it. The Blue Thunder Bomb could equal a Cruiserweight Championship reign for Charlie Tiger. Go get him, kid. As Jordan Oliver, the Sauce Guy, the champion, slow to get up, stopping Charlie Tiger
there's
in his chest.
No way he's letting this go down like this.
But they're not letting each other get high up on that ladder.
Oh.
Wow. Roundhouse kick to the temple. I think Tiger might be out on his feet. And now
on the ladder.
Oh, wow! Springboard off the ropes. Jordan Oliver was thrown off the ladder, springboard off the second rope, came back with an ace crusher. This action is unbelievable, Anthony.
I cannot believe this. I'm sitting here in awe watching every minute.
Non-stop action from bell to bell. Haven't heard that other bell sound yet. Still no champion crown as Ellis Taylor throws the Sauce Gun into the ladder. Could it be a possible monkey flip? Reversal now. Oh, a kick to the jaw of the champion, Ellis Taylor. Oh, Canadian Destroyer!
Jordan Oliver doing anything that he possibly can in order to win this, but Ellis is just one step ahead of him. Ellis is climbing the ladder now.
Oh my God!
Did you see that?
Sean, how could I have missed it? Unbelievable. Wow. All five of these competitors laying it all on the line. All five competitors are down as Casey, is that Casey Navarro? No, it's Max Stardom.
It's Max Stardom. You knew that he was down for the count, but he's back in this 100%, grabbing the ladder, bringing it right back to his center.
A lot of high-flying feats here, but only matters if you can reach superstardom by climbing the ladder of success, literally, and grabbing that Cruiserweight Championship. Sean Black joined by David Adams. We're watching this on commentary. Unbelievable that you get to witness this on social media. What an amazing ladder match, Cruiserweight Championship affair. This is Mega Slam 2018, and these competitors are holding nothing back, nor would we want them to. We've seen several competitors, Casey Navarro getting his hands on the title, come so close, but still not a champion. As we're getting deeper and deeper into this match, fatigue has to eventually become a factor.
As we have Navarro and Stardom at the top of the ladder, punch for punch.
A proverbial and actual ladder of success.
Which one of these men are going to fall?
A win here would be another notch in the belt for Casey Navarro, but a win for Max Stardom would shoot him to superstardom out of nowhere here at SWF, the Miami native. Now him and Casey Navarro, they both share that Miami sun. He's touching the gold, the leather, and the gold. But Navarro, very, very wiry. This kid can go.
What are we doing? What are you doing? What are you doing?
Out! Sunset flip powerbomb off the ladder! Are you kidding me?
Wow.
This is awesome. Clap, 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 clap. This is amazing. We thought this would go down as one of the most historic matches in SWF history, and it certainly has fit the bill. As now on the ladder of success, we have Jay the Key Evans and we have KC Navarro, a surprise fifth entrant in this match. Didn't even know that he was in town.
You're right about that. I know I did.
Oh, wow. Jay Evans left all alone on the top of that ladder.
You see that right hand taking Navarro out.
Wow. This is your opportunity, kid. Don't waste it. Can hardly reach his hand up the Bayville native. As the sauce god, knocking him off, but he gets knocked in the head in his own right. That ladder, it fights back. But now Jordan Oliver left all alone with a knot in his head to prove it. The war that he's been through, the war that these five gladiators have been through, clawing, scraping.
He grab it?
He got
and
it.
He does. Jordan Oliver showing that he is a fighting champion.
Wow.
What he went through in order to retain the gold tonight was by far some of the most amazing wrestling that I've seen today.
Pain, agony, anguish, but sheer determination and the will to win. The sauce guy, Jordan Oliver, proving he's not just some flash in the pan. He is a fighting and reigning SWF Cruiserweight Champion.
This man is here to stay.
Sean, I'm going back to ringside. We got us a street fight. It's coming up next here at Mega Slam.